the outpatient area where all the patients are coming in the morning. We have seen approximately 3,000 children so far coming from all around the region, Uganda, not only from Entebbe region. And we have performed over 500 major surgeries so far.
This hospital has got a number of interesting aspects. First of all, the concept by the founder who died recently and who was here when we launched it. This is a wonderful Christian concept of caring about your neighbor as you care about yourself. That's what the Bible says. This is the core of Christianity. So that founder must have been a real Christian, not just a nominal, but a real Christian. Although in Italy, I'm not sure there are also some communists, so I don't know exactly, but if he was a communist, then he was, there's also international solidarity among the communists. So either way, it is really good. So this is a very, very interesting aspect. Secondly, the concept of the construction, where the architect tried as much as possible to use nature. Because you remember recently there was a conference in Scotland about nature, about the climate. And part of the mishandling of the climate has been using all these unnatural things, or natural things, but in a bad way, because carbon is part of nature, and it has always been here. But the problem has been misusing it, using it in the wrong way. So that aspect of the architecture itself is interesting and unique. Then the third interesting factor is our donor, who obviously is a rich woman. Otherwise, where do you get $8 million from? But also interesting is that we in Uganda here, we associate richness with fatness. If you are rich in Uganda, you must be fat. If you are not fat, then you are not rich. But here we are, we have got a very slim, rich woman. Now, this is also another interesting factor. But also interesting is that this rich, smart, slim woman is coming from Venice. And when I last heard about Venice, it was not famous for philanthropy. It was the Merchant of Venice. Shylock, you know, the one who wanted a pound of flesh. But it seems Venice has changed tremendously since that time. And we have got philanthropic actors in Venice. I visited it. One of my friends took me there, and I was able to see that historic place. Then another interesting fact about the hospital is that I came to know this NGO through a very difficult friend of mine. This is Enrica Pinetti. But you know, human beings have been able to tame electricity. Electricity was wired in the lightning, but you tame it and you put it in the wires, and it does commendable work. So Enrica Pinetti is tamed electricity. And people who work with her, they always quarrel with her, but I say, you live with that comrade. She's a very good friend. She's very active, very energetic, but she will perform. You just tap her like we tap electricity. You will see how it works. Because she's the one who linked me with this group. One of the people I don't see here is the Somali woman doctor. I don't know what happened to that one, the Somali woman doctor, because she was, I don't know what she was doing in this group, but I remember her, she came with Pinetti. So I thank Pinetti for linking me with this philanthropic group. Now, coming to the land, that one was not so difficult because our special forces, we are looking after cattle here. They had quite some land here. They were using it as a cattle farm. So when I heard of a hospital for free treatment for children, I thought it was more important than looking after cows. So I said, okay, you people give us 30 acres. You can go and look after cows in Changwanzi, Chivoga, the other places where you can go and look after cows. But here, let us use this center for this life-saving effort. So, I'm happy that the municipality of Entebbe also did some commendable work. I thank you very much. I don't know what good they did. They did not mention it. But the minister alleged that you did a good work. Walikuwa tofali mateka kwa mateka kwa sato tofali chini katikitoa round na mwezo tofali mateka kwa. So therefore I'm really very happy to be here, and the permanent secretary has brought another idea of the nurses training center, which could be part of this. Because we have to think about that, how to partner with our friends, these devoted people from Italy, mixing Christianity with communism, with all that. We take advantage of that dedication, because you see, what you see here is dedication. This is what we are looking at here, dedication. Okulumirwa abantu keturaba wano. So if they could have a nursing center here, the nursing training school, where some of these people come and impart that passion, I call it passion plus skill. It is a combination of both. Because you may have a skill, but no passion. The skill will not be useful. So here you have both. You have both passion, but you also have skill. And if that nursing school could impart that to some of our young people, young nurses, it would be very good. The road would be done. It would be for sure, they have started working on it, but I can guarantee it would be tarmac, it would be asphalted. My staff should follow it up. We don't want dust coming to the hospital to spoil the equipment of the hospital. It's a pity that the founder died recently. That's what somebody said. Jesus died 2,000 years ago, but we remember him more than the people who are living now, because when he was alive, he did good work. So although Dr. Gino died, but he has left this living testimony of his country, of his character. And of his contribution deep here in the heart of Africa. You should tell the Italians that they have made something very, very special. They have built a children's saving hospital right on the equator, because the equator is not very far from here. That airport you see, the southern end of the runway, 200 meters in the water, that is the equator. So this is a children's specialized hospital on the equator. It is something remarkable. So I'm very happy to be here. And with these few words, I declare the hospital commissioned. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Excellency.